This entitled employee is about to reveal her disgusting habit that makes everyone around her want to throw up. When she's confronted about it, her shocking response is that she is proud and has no plans to change. Happy birthday, today's your birthday, and on with the revamped show. A little context. I moved to the UK last September for uni, and in November, I started working for a clothing retailer in my town. The shop is fairly big, 3 floors, and my role is to support it all, meaning I don't have a specific department. I get moved according to where I'm needed for the day. Now, onto the story. After my probatory period of 2 months, management had decided to keep me in the ladies section. During the day in which this story took place, my job was to take the clothes that customers had left in the fitting rooms after trying them on. If something didn't fit, you could leave it with the shop assistant at the exit of said fitting rooms, and put them back on display. So, since I had been working during the weekdays of my probatory period, I didn't know the weekend staff, nor the tremendous surprise that was waiting for me. Well, my shift starts. I take care of some clothes that have been left in the stockroom, and then enter the fitting rooms to get the rest. And oh boy, the worst smell I had ever smelled in my life hits my nose. It was like, I don't even know exactly how to describe it. Have you ever opened a full trash bin during the summer? Well, something like that. What made everything even worse is that the area where the unwanted clothes were kept was a small room, usually very hot too, with no ventilation. I tried my best not to gag at the smell, got a few clothes, and then left the fitting rooms as fast as I could. After a few hours of this, I finally gather the courage and go to one of the other employees. Am I the only one that smells this weird odor? Do you smell it too? She threw a quick glance around and then whispered to me, "Yeah, it's the girl that works in the fitting rooms. She's what causes this smell." I was shocked. I felt miserable just for being sweaty at the end of the day. How could she live like that without feeling horrible? After speaking with a few other colleagues, I found out that the situation was even worse than I thought. So, usually we have 2 people in the fitting rooms during the weekend. One stays at the front desk, our smelly girl in this case, and 2 stay in the small room mentioned above to get the unwanted clothes and make sure they are in order and ready to be displayed again. The smell was so bad that they had to contact management first and HR, then speak to her about the issue. She refused to listen to them and kept on with her smelly routine. Apparently, they couldn't do anything about it, so she was free to go on. At this point, management decided to take a small bottle of perfume and put it in the fitting rooms. Said bottle was to be used whenever she was around. This ordeal went on for a few months until, finally, a few weeks ago, she resigned and started working elsewhere. After she left, the fitting rooms kept smelling for a good 2 weeks until the only thing left to remind of her was the half-empty bottle of perfume. What shocked me even more, however, is when, last week, during a shift, I was chatting with a colleague about her and she told me that she not only didn't care about her smell, she was proud of it. So much that during her first day of work, she had announced, "Yeah, I don't wear deodorant." How can somebody be so smelly that they leave the place they work and 2 weeks later they can still smell their stank? I know HR said they couldn't do anything about it, but at some point, isn't it like a health hazard or something? Bring up some sort of hygiene clause? Risk of everyone throwing up because of the smell? I don't know. There's gotta be some way you can stop this. Okay, so this just happened to me a few hours ago, and it stands as the biggest WTF moment in my job. Little bit of background. I work as a contracted cell phone technician for a large superstore chain in my country. My job duties entail selling, activating phones, and assisting guests with technical issues with their phones. Due to me being a private contractor, I don't answer to any management staff or employee for the superstore, and I'm essentially my own boss. On top of this, I do have a right to decline service to anyone, however, I never do because I don't want to turn people away, just because they are having a bad day. But after what happened today, I'm going to enact my right to do so for any future encounters. So today, I was minding my own business when I was approached by the mythical Omega Karen, OK. OK was a 65-year-old woman who had what looked to be about 4 layers of makeup on her face and a beehive haircut so big she looked like she had a basketball underneath. Her hair looked like an Omega symbol too, hence why I call her Omega Karen. She explained to me that her phone was not working. Being the ever so helpful person that I am, I got to work in diagnosing the problem. After doing a quick inspection and tinkering around with the phone, I came to the conclusion that the phone was bricked. I informed OK of this revelation. The exchange went a little like this.
So what do we do now?
Well, ma'am, unfortunately the best course of action would be to replace the phone. Luckily, I have the same phone on sale for $49.99.
I'm not buying the phone. I bought the phone from here, so I want it exchanged.
Okay, ma'am, do you have the receipt for the old phone? This is when she went from a nice old lady to Omega level Karen.
Okay, listen here, you stupid piece of crud. I bought this phone almost a year ago. I don't have the receipt. I bought it here and it's now defective. Your company has to honor the guest and replace this broken piece of crud. And you're going to do it free of charge.
I soon realized this was going to be a train wreck, so I decided to try and Tai Chi the situation in an attempt to mitigate damage. Okay, ma'am, I understand that you're frustrated, but unfortunately due to the store's policy, we can't do any exchanges after 30 days of purchase. And after the words left my mouth, I realized that I messed up and she was ready to retaliate.
Bullcrap, you're just trying to scam me out of $50. I'm not having that. It's not my fault that it's a cheap piece of crud. If anything, it's your fault it's broken.
All my words were expended after hearing this. She actually was blaming me, a guy she's never seen before, of breaking her phone. Ma'am, I'm sorry, but there is honestly nothing the store can do for you. However, because you bought the phone less than a year ago, the warranty should still be replaceable through the carrier warranty. I would be happy to call. She interrupted me by picking up my stapler and threatened me with it.
Okay, you get me a fudging phone right now or I swear I will throw this at your freaking head.
Ma'am, threatening me is not going to solve your problem. Now, as I was saying, I can call up the carrier and see if they can replace it under their warranty. Okay, threw the stapler to the ground, breaking it, angrily grabbed her broken phone, told me to go fudge myself, and stormed off. After she left, I picked up the stapler and threw it out. I then continued with the next guest. Now, I wish it all ended here, but unfortunately, God hates me and wants to prove it. About 5 minutes after she stormed off, she returned. But she wasn't alone. OK did what every Karen dreams of doing and got the store manager. And it wasn't just him, but the security guy as well.
This guest has informed me that you won't assist her with her phone. Mind telling me why?
I explained the situation to the store manager, who was looking like he was about to hit me. He then interrupted me by saying,
"Okay, and then at what point did you throw a stapler at her?"
I was confused until it finally dawned on me. The person who threatened me was trying to frame me of assault over a $50 flip phone. I never, never did that. In fact, she was the one who threatened me with a stapler. OK interrupted me.
Bullcrap, you threw a stapler at me telling me that you were going to choke the life out of me. I want this man arrested for assault.
The security guy approached me. Is there any way you can corroborate your story? You can check the cameras. They most likely caught the whole interaction. As soon as I said the word camera, OK went ballistic.
How dare you believe this stupid punk over me? You should feel ashamed of yourselves.
Ma'am, we need to make sure we get the full details of the event so we can better explain it to the authorities.
I don't want to wait for the police. Just fire him and get me someone who can help me.
Ma'am? You said you wanted him arrested.
Stop putting words into my mouth, young man. Just fire this piece of crud.
This is when the store manager finally pipes up and tells her the bad news.
Unfortunately, ma'am, he's a private contractor that handles our phones. We can't fire him because he doesn't work for our company. Now, if he did what you said he did, it would be best to get video proof. That way we can escort him off the property.
OK relented and agreed to look at the footage. All four of us went to the security room to roll back the tape. As soon as we got to the part where she grabbed the stapler and held it up, OK started screaming.
This is bullcrap. All you fudges are in on it. I'm going to sue you all for tampering with evidence. I will see you all in court.
As she began to walk to the door, she noticed me smiling. I soon regretted doing this. OK smacked me across the face and spat at me. Luckily, SG heard the slap and quickly subdued her. After a quick call to the cops, she was handcuffed and put in the back of a squad car. The police asked if I wanted to press charges. All it took was one good look at her for me to say yes. Once I got done with the paperwork, the store manager apologized to me for what had happened. He informed me that OK was blacklisted and is to be arrested on site if she is to come back to the store.
People care about such petty things. It's not like it was even a really expensive phone, and the store explained that they couldn't replace it, but they were still willing to help them out with the manufacturer's warranty to get a replacement. So it's exactly what she wanted. Unless her ulterior motive was to frame them for assault, which I wouldn't put it past her. You gotta love a good story with a bit of irony. They unjustly demand that somebody gets arrested for assault, and that's exactly what ends up happening to them. So I'm a custom framer in a craft store. I had a customer come into my shop and she asked for a gold frame with a green mat to go with her painting. I said, okay, and started helping her out on finding the exact ones she wanted. It took over an hour and a half, but she left saying she was excited about getting it because she loves the design and how it looked in the mock-up on the computer. She comes in to pick up her art when it's ready, and honestly, I was excited for her to see it. I loved the way it came out, but instead I got, I can't say I love the green, shot through the heart. But it's whatever, people have a change of mind unfortunately though. I'm sorry to hear that, but if you want to change the mat, you'll have to buy a new one, which can be about 60 or so, just for the mat alone.
Well, I guess I'll live with it,
she says and leaves with a pout. I was disappointed she was unhappy, but unfortunately we have customers sign paperwork that says, I agree to the above design, and that if my art gets messed up in the process, the store owes me. And I can't just be handing out mat replacements because they changed their mind on the design as much as I wish I could. Next day I was working and the store gets a call.
Hi, yeah, I came in yesterday to pick up my art and I'm just not happy with it. I'm looking at the paperwork and it looks like there was a mock-up of my art on a computer, but the framer never showed me the screen, and honestly, I felt rushed the whole way through with her.
I recognized the voice and only had one unhappy customer the day before. So, is this last name? It was quiet for a second, probably because I knew who she was, but I finally got a
yes.
Okay, so I'm the framing manager and the framer that assisted you for your order. I never have the computer facing me directly when working with customers, as well as you nixed some matte colors based on the computer image alone, as well as we spent well over an hour, so I can guarantee you weren't rushed. Again, it was quiet until,
well, I'm just not happy with the piece then.
I'm sorry you're unhappy with your choice, but unfortunately, you signed a form stating that's the look you wanted, and it's what was given. Any changes you want done comes at a charge. I can give you a 50% discount, but we won't replace it for free.
Fine,
hangs up the phone. She never came back. To be fair, sometimes mockups on a computer don't come out the same when it's actually a physical form. It really depends how different it is from what you were expecting, from what they showed you and you're expecting to what you actually get given. So I mean, fair enough if she had a problem and she didn't think it looked like what was on the computer, but don't go lying about it. Especially when you call up, why do these people never think, maybe I'm going to speak with the person who's the person who can verify if it actually happened or not. They just straight up like, yeah, I was there the other day and they just didn't show me the computer screen. Yo, that was me. You don't have anything to say now, do you? They're just sitting at home looking at the frame, getting angrier and angrier.
I don't like it, Harold. I'm gonna call him.
Then call him, what do I care?
I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna tell him. They didn't even show me the computer.
Whatever.
Submit your story to be read on the channel at voiceyhearstories@gmail.com and join our Voicey veteran community at r/voiceyhear. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell to never miss an episode. All right, Voicey veterans, I'll see you in the next one.